Meow.
Good. All right, very good. Now that that's out of your systems, welcome back after some. Are you fucking kidding me?
You had to see that coming.
I will admit, I haven't done that in weeks.
I saw it coming.
That one.
She definitely hasn't done it in New Orre in weeks.
Aw, now I'm sad.
Okay, now that that's out of your systems, oh god, I said that. I can't believe I said that.
Meow.
Welcome back, after quite some time, to Fallout New Orre. I am your host and evil mastermind DM, Bucky, and these are my lovely players, although I question that when they do shit like this.
Players, yes. Lovely, no, fuck.
Are you seriously?
I'm okay. Having some trouble shaking this accent.
Layla will now have us.
Why?
That's the game.
Because it's fun.
Okay. Okay, everything's fine.
I have no idea where it's from. I'm going to say Draenei or something. Okay, I'm gonna mute again.
Oh my god. Alright,
Now you know how I feel.
So you feel great?
No.
Okay. You lie. Okay, so we last left off where let's see. That's right. It was this big session of Jolene talking to and teenagers talking to each other. Well, Jolene talking to not all of them are teenage, young adults, let's call them young people.
Everyone's a youngin' compared to Jolene.
Okay, fair, but all these people talking about their romantic feelings for each other and for multiple people at the same time and trying to figure out how to handle this, Jolene explaining how to handle this. It was a lot. And like even the Alolan Ninetales got in on it when he went and tried to talk to Cadis, but then Plo ruined everything.
Plo.
Plo just wants to protect her older sister. God damn it, mac and cheese.
Well, Plo wasn't even trying. Plo didn't even know what they were doing. I mean, he was doing. Plo was just like Plo was just like, when he asked what type Cadis is, he was like, she's clearly not your type, because you're ice type and she's fire type. But, so Plo didn't even know.
Plo was accidentally protecting her bigger sister.
Plo is the world's tiniest cock blocker.
Well, there's two interpretations of that term.
Good.
Oh my god. Why am I here? Okay.
To suffer, Bucky. To suffer.
Is that why you're here?
Of course.
You hurt me, Hunter.
Don't take that tone of voice when you're not being the DM.
Oh.
You're doing me a heckin' big frighten, Hunter.
Bucky.
What?
Bucky.
What?
He's coming for you.
I hate you. I hate you. Z. Okay.
Hatter. Hatter. Yes. Hatter. Noodle.
Noodle. Okay. So that's where we last left off. As I recall, Layla's up in her room processing everything. Deli, I'll let you handle how all that works out. I'm not sure where everyone else was physically.
Leilani was just off at, I believe that her name.
That's right. He was helping out at the like farm and like gardening and stuff.
Yeah.
Spark, after having a very, very riveting conversation with Kane and then Jake and then Jolene. She's gone and run off to find Layla to tell her the good news, because she does not know that Layla is hiding in her room.
All right. So do you head to the HL house?
Yep.
Gwen and Ariel are still hanging around outside chatting with each other.
Hey, have you guys seen Layla anywhere?
Dally says in the chat, Spark, I have grown so much as a character, and it's exhausting.
Poor Spark.
Anyway, so you approach and ask if you guys seen Layla. They glance at each other uncomfortably, and Gwen looks at you, and she says, she's kind of, listen, Mom and Mama kind of asked her to stay home for a while, and she's hanging out up in her room trying to think about it.
And Spark has gotten running into the house upstairs.
Alright. So you head upstairs. Layla's parents look a bit surprised, but they don't stop you, because, like, well, anyways, so you head upstairs and head to Layla's room.
He doesn't back me up before she goes inside.
Outside right. the door, you will find a Sprague.
Hi, Sprague.
Can Spark understand Pokemon or just Eggsy? Yes. I forget. Okay, cool.
Hello. Layla asked me to make sure no one disturbed her.
Well, then, can you go and deliver a message for me, then?
Sprig looks like she is in a sudden quandary. Oh.
She doesn't know how this works.
But then, would I be would I be disturbing her if I did that? Am I allowed to do that? And she calls to the door. Layla, am I allowed to disturb you? Layla actually opens the door a crack and peers out. Sprig, what? Oh, hi, Spark.
Hey, Layla.
Hello.
Everything?
Oh, yeah, sorry, I got a lot to think about. I had a long talk with Mom and Mama, and, that's not important right now. What's up? Oh, did you talk to Kane?
Yeah, that was a conversation.
Yeah. Yeah, I guess it would have been. Oh, sorry. And she opens the door. Wanna sit down? Or anything?
Yeah.
Instead of sitting down, Layla just paces awkwardly.
No good.
So how are you?
I'm okay. The conversation went well, I think. I don't really, no. I just know that he said he needs time to think about things, and Jake was being awkward, and Jolene got involved, and it was,
Well, it's something. Probably a good thing Jolene got involved, because she usually knows what she's talking about. And yeah. It makes sense that Kane would need time to think about things. Jake being weird about stuff is new, though. Usually it's Leilani.
Yeah, he was just kind of, he had apparently was reading my mind, I guess, and asked if I needed help, and then came over, and then it didn't end up as well as we thought it would.
Oh, hold up, Jake can read minds now?
Apparently.
Oh.
Either that or he was delivering a message through,
Emma?
Emma, thank you, I can't remember her name. Emma, I don't know. But then, like, right when we finished talking, Jake had said, like, asked if, like, when Kane had asked if that was the kind of relationship he wanted, and I said yes, and then, Jake said, I do too.
Oh.
And then ran out.
Okay. And then what?
And then he ran off.
Oh. Okay. Maybe to talk to Leilani? Jake likes Leilani back, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah, I thought he did. I just can't always tell, you know? Okay, so Jake's got some figuring stuff out to do. So is Kane. Leilani might as well. And, I guess we do? Possibly?
What? I missed what you said, Dolly.
She's just saying it seems like everyone has stuff to sort out, including us.
Yeah, we do.
She is scratching her head awkwardly.
You want to sit down too? I can move over.
Okay.
She sits down next to Spark and is visibly blushing.
I'm sorry, am I making you uncomfortable?
No. I just never really thought it would get this far. I kind of thought that when I told you, it would just be that you didn't like me back. And I don't really know where to go from here.
Neither do I.
You've had some experience with relationship stuff, right? Because with Kane?
You see, the last time we had a chance to be alone, we opened the door to, like, Kane was leaving, and Shirley kind of punched him in the face.
Layla looks up and looks very angry.
I don't like that guy.
He had come home early. I guess he found out something. He must have been watching. I'm not sure how.
Well, he's really possessive and evil. So maybe he was spying on you somehow?
Yeah.
Oh, ew. Ew. You don't spy on people like that, especially not your own sister. Ah! Ah! I just want to take a shower just thinking about him. Sorry, Spark. I can't imagine what it's like for you having that as a brother. Blech.
Yeah. Let's just say after that moment I stopped changing in my room.
Oh. Uh-huh. Well, for what it's worth, you can have, like, more privacy and stuff here. Okay, so it's a house with, like, 6 people in it. But but apart from that, privacy is kind of hard to come by when there's this many people in one house, especially since we got extra people in. But, you know, we still try and respect each other's privacy, and I'm rambling.
Yeah, I mean, if I'm really desperate for privacy, I can always just, you know, go outside and become a rock for a little bit.
Oh, yeah. That must be pretty useful. Just make sure that Zazu doesn't try and eat you.
It kind of doesn't work if too many things interact with it, or if I lose focus, so I don't think.
In which case, I really hope Zazu doesn't try and eat you, because then she'd get really scared.
Yeah.
Start checking all the rocks to see if they're people.
Yeah.
Anna says this has to happen now.
What do we do now, Spark? I know it's probably obvious, but, I do still like you and stuff. I mean, it's okay if you change your mind and sorry, I've never really liked anyone before, and no one's ever really liked me before, and
It's okay, Layla. I understand. New experiences can be scary.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I mean, it's not... Like, I'm kind of scared, but I don't know if that's the right word exactly, because I'm not scared of you. I mean, I feel safe around you. Like, even though we haven't known each other that long. I mean, just pretty soon after I met you, I just felt like it was okay to be around you. That, you know, you were a good, kind person who was gonna look out for people, you know, and, you know, someone I wanted to be friends with, and so it was really nice being around you, and then it was so nice being around you that it got confusing, and I wasn't sure what it meant, because I'd never had feelings for anyone before, and then, I think the part where it got scary was that I got really scared of hurting you. Because I don't want to do that. And I wouldn't mean to. I'd never hurt you on purpose, but what if I do it by accident?
Yes, I'm really worried about you getting hurt because of me.
Oh. That hadn't even occurred to me. I kind of figured that I wouldn't get hurt because you keep me safe. You're good at that. Keeping people safe, I mean, in general. Cause you're a badass and stuff. Don't tell Mom I said that.
I don't want to promise.
I mean, I want to protect you, too. I want to be as strong as you and make a difference. And you know, I know you could probably handle stuff yourself, but I want to make sure none of those people back in Mount Battle hurt you anymore. I kind of need to tell all the others this, but maybe I should tell you first. I was talking to Mom and Mama, and they heard on the radio about the increased Team Storm activity in the area, and sightings of, well, maybe the Kindred, but maybe the Ascendants, you know, just people in power armor. And I told them about the people in the Under, and they hadn't known for sure about that, and they were appalled, obviously, and I said that we wanted to go and save them, like how the Costas saved us, and they kind of freaked out a bit. Like, they totally agreed that we have to get them out. But they've been worrying about me a lot, and I've been getting into a lot of trouble that they didn't agree to when I first left home. So they asked me to have a serious think about maybe staying home for a bit. And I said that I couldn't do that forever, and they said they understood that.
And Bucky, feel free to, Hello?
Hi.
Oh, no worries. Bucky, I'm kind of just estimating what Lyra and Cicely would say, so feel free to jump in and correct me if you think I've got it wrong at any point.
No, this is fine.
Cool.
This is all, you know, what we decided on for, you know, keeping Layla home, like, as the character. So, anyway,
yep.
Point being, yeah, this is all fine.
Okay, cool. So,
they wanted me to have a serious think about that, and like, at first I was like, I can't do that, but I'm not as strong as the rest of you. Not yet. I still have some stuff to learn. Like, there have been a couple of times where when scary stuff happened, I just kind of seized up and didn't know what to do. And I think I'm more likely to put myself and others in harm's way if I keep doing that. So, Mom and Mama and I made a deal that I'd stay home for a bit, and once I can prove to them that I'm strong enough to look after myself, I can come and join you guys again.
Okay.
I don't want to leave you guys, but I also don't want to be... I don't want to be putting anyone in danger, and I don't want to make Mom and Mama worry so much. They've been really understanding so far, like letting me go in the first place, and I feel like I owe it to them to make sure they know I'm going to be okay. So I'm going to stay here and train for a while, and they said like when I've trained up for a bit I can go on expeditions outside the city with Gren and Ariel, and just, you know, train and, you know, research a bit more about medicine and stuff like that. And Sprig and I were talking a bit. Sprig? Sprig comes in and sits on Spark's head.
Hello.
Hello again.
In case anything goes badly wrong, and you guys, I mean, you probably wouldn't, but just in case you might need help getting out of a jam, Sprig's gonna come with you, and that way, if you need me, she can come and get me, and I'll come and do something. Probably bring reinforcements. And Sprig sort of nestles on Spark's hair and goes,
I will be your new hat.
Okay. If you feel as best they will.
I'm not 100%, but I was talking with Mom and Mama, and I was talking to Sprig, and I was talking to Hodge for a bit, and that was really confusing.
You asked Hodge for advice?
No. When I say I talked to Hodge, I mostly mean he talked to me.
Okay.
Not sure where he is right now. I think he and Milo went to go check on Mikey. Anyway, I'll tell the others this, but I don't want to drag them away from stuff they're doing right now, so I guess next time you're all convening here, I'll let everyone know, or something like that. I feel really weird, conflicted, I think, about this, because... And she just looks over at Spark and looks a little worried. If I do this, is it abandoning you?
You're a person. I can completely understand.
Thank you. And she leans forward and looks like she's going to hug Spark, but she hesitates, like, wait, I'm not sure if I should do that.
She holds her arms out for a hug.
Layla just smiles a little and hugs. Thanks, Spark. You're really good.
You're way better than me.
I don't think so. She pulls back and looks at her. And just very shyly reaches out and sort of sweeps a little bit of hair back from her face. But then she gets self-conscious and kind of puts her hand down again.
Do it!
Shut up. But yeah, she's tucked a bit of Spark's hair behind her ear and then folded her arms and gone. I think you're a lot better than you realize. I hope you can see that soon.
God damn it, guys!
They're not going to, because, you know, they still need to see how Kane feels about it.
Do it.
You guys are the worst. Polyamory is about NPC. Trust He'll and communication. Fine. Hannah! You're supposed to be the team mother. Stop encouraging this.
Are you saying that team mothers shouldn't encourage their children?
Encourage responsible communication within complicated relationship. Okay.
Keith.
Shipper trash.
Encourage love.
Oh my goodness. Anyway, Layla is fidgeting with her hands at this point. Was there anything else you wanted to talk about?
Well, if you're staying here, maybe I can, leave some of my Pokemon here just to keep an eye on this way.
Really? I mean... Well, whatever you think, because, I mean, if you need them.
And Izzy, I think Eggsy and Katie's can handle most things. Well, if I'm absolutely really needing to. But after what happened back at, I am blanking on all the names.
Which incident?
Pyrite, that's it.
Pyrite, okay.
After what happened in Pyrite Town, I don't want to put any of my Pokemon in that kind of danger again.
Oh. Well, no, that's fine. I mean, heck, we already have like a dozen Pokemon running around here. A few more won't make a difference. They can stay here and we can look after them and they can train if they want to. That's the thing I could do. Like, I mean, my Pokemon are weak against fire, so it would be really good for them to train against some fire types.
And Steve.
I'm sure we'll find something useful for Steve to do.
At least for him to grow back until he grows back.
Yeah, he can have he can have some rest while he recovers and gets his tail back.
Yeah.
She giggles a little. And then, maybe a month after he's grown his tail back, he'll notice that he's grown his tail back, and that'll be nice for him.
Yeah, that one.
I'll look after them while they're here, I promise.
Okay.
There's probably more stuff to sort out, but I should probably wait until we're all together as a group to do that. I feel like I kind of put a lot on you already, to be honest, but thanks for listening and for understanding. It really means a lot to me.
You're welcome.
At this point, Milo appears at the door wearing Hodge on his back.
Excuse us, humans. We need to have a talk with Mother. I mean, Layla.
My goodness.
What's up, Hodge?
We have things that need to be discussed.
Oh my god, I'm sorry. Hodge is channeling Tom Nook. Stop that. Geez. Bad Hodge. It's been so long since I've played them.
We stared into the abyss and we owe it money.
Okay. Hodge gets down from Milo's back and scuttles in and climbs up Layla's leg and settles into her lap.
Hello.
Hi, Hodge. Milo also comes up and attempts to climb onto Layla's lap also. Finds no room, climbs onto her shoulders instead.
What?
Spark, would it be okay if I had a word with the boys about whatever this is about?
Yeah, I gotta go find Eggsy. I don't know what he ran off to, and that's starting to concern me.
Remember, he ran off to...
I'm aware that he ran off to go and hit rocks with his head.
Good!
Yes.
Layla, oblivious of this, says, I'm sure he's fine, but yeah, you do
that. I'm running Rock Smash!
He and Tad ran off to smash rocks with their heads, and Plo wanted to go join them, but Cadus is like, no, Plo, you stay with me.
Zazu is with them.
Oh my god!
Is Zazu eating the particles that fly towards Zazu?
Zazu is mostly occasionally snacking on them like they're popcorn, but is mostly keeping a very wary eye on them in case they're training to murder her.
Oh my god!
Good.
Because of course.
Because she's Brock.
Okay. Wouldn't she then believe that the popcorn that she's eating is poisoned?
Oh no, they're clearly training for a frontal assault. Also, she has very limited willpower.
Well, but they might be clever enough for a double ruse.
Yes, but Zazu's not clever enough to think of them being clever enough.
It's Eggsy, it's Tad!
Maybe the entire thing has been a front. I don't know.
It's Eggsy!
Look, in the mind of a paranoid, it doesn't matter.
That's fair, actually.
If I started Eggsy to be a D&D character, his intelligence would be 6.
I think that's a little generous.
Be nice to Eggsy.
If I go any lower, he becomes catatonic.
Be nice to the potato.
Depends on the version of D&D.
Be nice to the hot potato.
I can do what I want to my potato.
She has a point.
No, don't abuse the hot potato.
It is not abuse. It's the truth. Anyway, Spark then goes...
Didn't you miss us, Alistair?
Yeah, actually. Okay. So Spark...
Spark leaves Layla alone. I'm guessing Sprig is going with her because... He hasn't specifically taken...
You will find that Sprig is still on your head being tall.
Cool.
Kind of slow. Like, once she leaves and closes the door, she just kind of slowly puts Sprig back down on the ground and then goes back and walks off.
Sprig looks at Spark, looks at Layla's door, and looks confused. Wait, am I supposed to go with Spark now or keep guarding the door? Inside, she can hear Hodge loudly explaining something. I'll stay here in case Layla needs me. To save her. From Hodge.
Mm-hmm. From Hodge.
Sounds about right.
I just remember a while ago when I think Leilani made it clear that he's able to understand understand all Pokemon now. Sprig was just like, wait, that means you can understand Hodge? I'm so sorry.
Accurate.
Amazing.
But anyways, one moment. I need to message someone.
Eli, you've been a bit quiet so far. Just wanted to check that you're still mic working and stuff.
I believe so.
Okay, good. Can still hear you. Sorry, I'm getting to the point where if I haven't heard from anyone, I start getting paranoid.
Huh. Like, oh, Zazu.
Like Zazu. Oh, but you see, Hatter, Zazu gets paranoid when she doesn't hear from people, and when she does. Zazu is in fact paranoid all the time.
Yes.
Don't
hope a little bit of character development. Now she is only paranoid for 23 hours a day.
I'm so proud of her. Such character growth.
And the other hours she sleeps.
Well, at least she
only sleeps for the hour because she's too paranoid that someone would kill her in her sleep.
Mm-hmm. But it's still growth.
At least now she actually does sleep.
Yeah.
She sleeps. Okay, where does Spark
head? Aaron just does all the sleeping for my party. You guys didn't know, but I gave her a skill that allows her to distribute it.
Well, that's why she sleeps all the time. Makes sense now.
When you head downstairs, Spark, you notice Banzai asleep in the corner, in a corner at least, with Mikey asleep on her head. And you notice Fang curled up on the couch, and he lifts his head to watch you as you pass by, and Friend is nearby, like near him, curled up.
Spark is just kind of like looking at him and looking at him for a moment, and then walks out the door.
All right. Okay, is there anything anyone else wants to do?
Yes. Over the earpieces, Quinn will say, hey, look, when everyone's not busy, we need to talk about the next plan of action. I'm in Jolene's place.
Jolene, where is her place?
Jolene's place is near Rachel's. I think everyone knows that in canon.
I don't think Spark's ever been, so.
No, I think we went, like, 2 episodes ago, the last time we had this conversation about whether or not Jolene actually had a place in town.
Well, I think maybe Quinn did, but Spark did not.
Fair. Either way, Jolene has a place. At least some of the party has been there.
Insert description of where that place is and how to get there here.
Leilani, you'll go there.
Same with Spark.
If they're going now, Layla will follow. Avex Brig.
Okay.
Hodge and Milo are staying at the Hartigan Lamont household, discussing things with each other. Pip joins in. So yes, are we all going to Jolene's then?
Okay. What do you guys do once you're there?
Quinn has on one of the tables, the large thing of paper that he bought is stretched out over it, and he has painstakingly drawn on one half a map of the area, like a world map, and on the other a known map of the Ascendant's headquarters. He has spent several hours making sure that it was at least acceptable.
Whoa, Quinn.
And he is just staring down at it intently.
You're good at that.
Jolene has been right here knitting, and at least as far as like anyone can see, calmly watching Quinn.
What was Spark saying?
Can you make that just a little bit wider?
Based on, can Spark and Layla between them, because Spark grew up there and because Layla has Chronicler, make sure it's an accurate as map as possible?
Well, this is actually partially using information that Spark has given Quinn.
Ah.
Because Quinn's been like, okay, I need you to tell me everything you know, or everything that you can tell me. And also his own memory of being there. Huh. But there's definitely blank spots that he has no information on. So it's just what he knows.
My room is there.
He draws it. You know what? He gives it to the Chronicler.
Layla is going to start sketching in.
Yeah, no, because he's... I have to clear this with the DM, but he's been doing this for several hours, and it's just so I didn't have to roll.
In the section that has that she's just drawn Spark's room into, she says, "Former location of most awesome former ascendant."
Okay. A truly business-like map.
Business. Numbers. Is this working?
It's working, guys.
Quinn, you must have spent ages on this.
Hours, yes.
Wow. Thank you. So, what did you want to talk about?
Okay. I know this opinion's going to be disliked, but I'm going to put it out there. I think we need to quickly take care of everything we need to do, and then, you know, get Shirley's friend out, find Sholay, kick his ass, the whole thing, and then grab everyone that we know, friends, family, everything, and get the hell out of Dodge.
Get the hell out of...
New War.
What? Get out of New War?
Yes.
Why?
I'm sorry, did I hear a different radio broadcast than you?
New War is our home, Quinn.
There's a war brewing.
Yeah, and we'll fight in it. I mean, you don't have to.
And we're on the losing side.
I'm not abandoning my home.
You're both.
It's not the worst thing you can do.
You're both right.
We have no chance. In the... Sorry, out of character. What's the... what was the world that Pokemon Satan was from?
Dimension something?
Distortion
something?
World.
There's no way in the... In all of... You know, fuck it. I mean, there's no way in hell that we're gonna stand a chance. Even if we were to somehow convince the Republic, who is not a great option, but is... supposedly the best one out of the... is definitely the best one out of three. By the way, I don't like them all too much, and they definitely don't like me. But they're the best option, and they were woefully unprepared for what they're going to find here in New World.
Hold on, wait. You know the Republic?
Yeah, the second comes back.
Yeah.
I may or may not owe them a lot of money and prison time.
Uh-huh.
That explains why you want to get out of here so fast.
I was going to say...
No, I can face...
And says there's worse people to owe a lot of money in prison time to.
Well, yes, but look, I can take care of that.
Jolene, who do you owe money in prison time to?
Well, I owe somebody a few things.
Bump shotgun.
Spark under her breath just kind of murmurs.
What?
Spark just kind of murmurs under her breath, they're probably all dead now.
Not all of them.
Look, I can skirt under the radar with a false name and new face, but that doesn't matter. The Republic is the best option of the three, possible four, armies that are going to be here, and they are woefully unprepared for what's going to happen.
Four armies?
Even if...
So what?
We...
The New and Over Republic, the Ascendants, Team Storm, and... I guess the Kindred?
Possibly the Kindred. Still unclear on that. It is a possibility, though.
The
just putting it up.
The Ascendants aren't exactly planning war. I mean, they are kind of, but they're not acting immediately. And Team Storm has increased activity, but... You can tell, actually, Layla does look very concerned about what the hell Team Storm is doing.
The Republic is coming here to fight what they see as an overgrown... Raider gang, Team Storm. They are not prepared for the Ascendants, which I remind you, according to most of
they're
the people in
the
war, is a legend.
They're also not prepared for Team Storm.
True, Team Storm is probably more than they're expecting, but they're still just expecting an overgrown Raider gang. They're not expecting people that are completely self-sufficient in their own mountain that has tech better than they do. We're about to enter there's about to be a war, and we're smack dab in the middle of it. With two sides that have the technology to start another great war, and a third that, if they got their hands on it, would be willing to do so in a moment's notice.
You're just gonna leave everyone else here to suffer.
Because we can't take everyone with us. I mean, half the people here are refugees to start with. You expect them to have to pick up their lives and run away again?
Honey, last I checked, We didn't fight in wars because, hang on, background
noise. While Hannah's muted, can I just check, Bucky, it's been a while since I listened to the broadcast. Does our recollection of it line up with what Quinn is saying?
I would say yes. Okay. Like I said,
they're mobilizing.
You've heard that all the major factions in the area are mobilizing. That can't be good.
Okay, and that the New Inner Republic are coming here. They have said that, haven't they? Yeah, they did say that, didn't they?
Yeah, they've already got a presence semi-established here. They've got, like, you know, small, you know, very tiny outposts, and, like, they've got a little base in Pyrite Town, but yes, they've basically announced, okay, we're going to increase our presence to protect the good people of New Orre, and they're definitely totally trustworthy, and not at all a corrupt government.
And not patronizing. Yeah, but
out of the three, they are the best choice, and Quinn hates saying that, but...
Well, we're not arguing on that point, we're arguing on the running away point. Hannah, has your background noise stopped?
Yes.
Cool. Do you want to finish what Jolene was saying?
Honey, we don't fight wars because we can win them. We fight the wars that need fighting.
One sec, my dogs are barking like hell, I'll be right back.
Okay.
The drama of this scene is really hinged on the timing, I think.
Yeah, I didn't expect this intensity here. Like, I'm liking it.
Yeah, me too. I like it. Quinn's coming out of his shell and shit's going down.
Yeah.
Be right back. I need to get something more to drink.
Bork.
We take a moment from this intense drama for things happening in the background.
For borking.
Bork. Such bork.
I'm sorry, I just glanced at my computer and I noticed a headline. Woman gets 20 boyfriends to buy her iPhones, then sells them to buy a house.
I think I remember that. Hang on, I'm gonna mute for a sec.
I mean, like, honestly, if you can do it, like, go you, man. Like, more power to you.
Ow!
You alright?
I hit my head.
No! Andrea hurt herself in her confusion.
Is that still gone?
Yeah. Hunter, are you back? No.
Okay, I'm back, sorry.
Oh, there he is!
Hunter, back!
Yeah, sorry, what?
Okay, so I think Quinn was responding to Jolene.
Speak of the devil, and in this case, it's quite literal because Hunter's the fucking devil.
Yes.
Okay, Quinn says, look, this is how this is going to play out. Out of character, the Republic is coming from the east, correct?
Yes.
Yeah, okay. The Republic is going to enter from the east in this here. The Team Storm probably already have a staging ground somewhere here along the southern coast. That's probably why they attacked port. So they'd have a staging ground for whatever's going to happen next. They're going to clash, and whatever's in their way is going to get demolished. Once they figure out that, you know, they're up against something a bit stronger than just, you know, your overgrown raider gang.
Much stronger,
yeah. They're going to send for reinforcements, more supplies, more people, everything. And eventually, I'm not saying it's even going to be quickly. There's going to be a lot of lives lost here. Eventually, Republic will take out Team Storm. Eventually. But in that time, the Ascendants, who, by the way, are a myth to most of the New World region, are going to infiltrate, because that's what they do. They're going to infiltrate the Republic and start getting people in high-ranking positions. Now, we have an entire entire group of people that's supposedly on our side being run by the enemy. And even if that wasn't the case, and the Ascendants decide to throw away all the cloak and dagger and decide to fight them head-on, they have power armor and weaponry, and they're starting to put types into their tools. We cannot fight that. The Republic is good because they have numbers and training. They are not prepared for any of this. At best, we're going to be under the rule of the Ascendants under a different name. At worst, it's going to be a slaughtering ground.
No. No, that's not what's going to happen, because we have us. We stopped...
have a Hulk.
We stopped Team Storm before. I know that it was just... I know that it was the lower ranking members of this of the team, and that there are much, much worse. I know that. But we beat them. We got in and out of that battle. We got in and out of the under. We have people on our side. We have Spark, who is basically a superhero. You can be anyone. Leilani is really good with, I want to say plants. Sorry, it's been a while.
Leilani just looks at Layla and says, "No, it's all right. I'm useless."
No, I don't mean.
I think Deli was asking out of character. Yeah. I want to say plants.
Yeah, so. That's what I was saying. I it's been a while, and I can't remember everyone's skill set. I remember that, and that Spark has.
You were correct.
Psychic. Okay.
And also flying.
Flying. Yeah.
Yeah, but I don't actually have the secondary trainer type. That I want to have yet.
I thought you had plant.
No, because remember there was weird shit with his class.
Yeah.
Oh, right. He can't take that until later. I remember now. He's got the other thing. Okay. Look, I don't care. I don't care if it makes me stubborn or naive or stupid. I didn't survive the first 4 years of my life against all that stuff, against the Team Storm raid, against being sold to the Under, against all that. I didn't go through that to just run away from the family I made. I don't care. If they're gonna die, then I'm gonna die with them.
No one's going to die.
Yeah. We're not.
Iolana takes a deep breath and says, "No, people are gonna die."
Shut up, Iolana.
No, listen. Listen. We have skills that Team Storm and the Ascendants and the NUR don't know about.
All right, though. People are gonna die. We're just going to put some effort in to make sure it's the right people.
Yeah, fine. I... Listen. We have things that people don't know we have. We have eyes and ears inside certain places. We have ways of getting inside Mount Battle. We have knowledge of Team Storm, of how they work. And what's more, we have allies. People that we've helped and who've helped us. If there's going to be four, or however many it is, factions clashing, well, let's add our own to it. Us, and the Costas, and anyone we can get from Phenac and Pyrite and Gateon and Moors.
Sorry, my Skype's crashed.
Oh.
Yeah!
There we go. Okay.
And we have Shelly on our side, and we'll have Shiloh too once we get them out.
Mm-hmm. Look, I'm not even saying Team Storm isn't an issue here. They are. But they're the lesser of two here.
You keep saying that. The Ascendants didn't kidnap a bunch of children and sell them into slavery, Quinn. Stop downplaying that. I admit that the Ascendants are bad, but stop saying that they're worse than Team Storm, because that really, really hurts.
Okay.
They are both bad.
Yes. I'm saying in a war, in between a fight between everyone, the Ascendants have Team Storm outmatched.
You're only saying that because you've actually faced against the Ascendants. You haven't faced Team Storm.
They have them outnumbered, outgunned, and they're totally self-sufficient.
Bucky, is that actually true?
He said that the mountain's self-sufficient.
Yeah, no. I mean, is it true that... No. Is it true that the Ascendants actually have Team Storm out everything? Like, is what Quinn's saying accurate?
I mean, you don't exactly know Team Storm's numbers, and Team Storm themselves could very well be self-sufficient as well.
I know that the Ascendants have a mountain, but Team Storm have an island?
Yeah, they do have an island. It's not as big as the mountain, but they still, have an island that, they use for their shit. So...
Okay, I just want to make sure that I'm not, like... I want to make sure that I'm kind of going in somewhat informed, and I'm not,
You're fine.
Okay.
You're fine. You can't be sure about their numbers, but they are self-sufficient. The only difference you can be sure about is that the Ascendants are more technologically advanced. And even then...
Spark would know, how big the residential area is, right? And that all, and if all the rooms are, all the places are filled up, right?
Hatter, I'm not really debating how many Ascendants there are, more how many Team Storm members there are, which we don't have any way of knowing.
Yeah.
I mean, there can literally only be so much space on the island. And even if the numbers
were... Well, they're not just limited to the island. Yeah. That's their base of operations.
And to also kind of counteract the point, even if all the residential areas are filled, that's not all military.
That's true. Yeah. There's a lot of civilians.
Well, that's the point I was going to get to, was that, everyone, every single male in Team Storm is hardcore trained to fight. Not every single human being in the Ascendants is hardcore trained to fight. So even though they have better technology, Team Storm has significantly a greater percentage of, pure warriors.
What the impression I'm getting is that the Ascendants are incredibly calculated and that Team Storm are incredibly vicious. I mean, it's the Enclave and Caesar's Legion. That's what they're XP's for. That scene in
300 where he's like, Spartans, what are your profession? And then he's like, I brought more soldiers than you.
Lol.
Yeah.
Everyone's seen that scene, right? I'm not just talking out of my ass here.
No, yeah, no.
I know.
Is it bad that when I saw that scene as a kid, when I watched the movie, I just thought, what an asshole.
I mean, you're not wrong. Like, that is a completely correct interpretation of that scene.
Like, they're coming to help you. Stop being a dick.
Okay.
Good.
So, anyways, yeah, your interpretation is correct. Team Storm is vicious.
And the numbers are unknown, so that is the next factor.
Yeah, I'm also just speaking out of character... Their XPs are the Enclave and the Legion. They're both equally fucked. Fucked up.
Yeah, they're equally fucked, but the difference between the Legion and the Enclave is that the Legion will rip you to half with a shredder, while the Enclave is going to blow you up with a nuke from a Vodabut.
The end result is kind of the same.
Yeah, well, but if I put it in a fight between a unit and a Vodabut...
I'm also... Yeah. Mm.
Consider.
I'm also.
This is also Pokemon.
This is also Pokemon, true.
Yeah.
But, everyone has weapons of mass destruction.
Yeah. Everyone. From a young age.
Yeah, it's very true. Even 10-year-olds
have them.
Yes. Even 10-year-olds have weapons of mass destruction in this world.
Which, okay, so that also. Actually, I was going to say that, which puts the Ascendants slightly on edge, but actually doesn't, because the Ascendants have purebreds, but they also have, like, these strange fusions, while the Because Team Storm would have mutants.
Yeah, I'm just saying, I think they're on the same level.
Yeah, I would, honestly, the only, without knowing everything about Nur and Team Storm.
The other thing that he brings up is that they are vicious and they're in your face. Ascendants have proven they are cloak and dagger. Like, that's the whole point, is they are a myth.
I'm also just wanting to be cautious here because I don't want us to get into any kind of my backstory villain is worse than your backstory villain stuff. And that's kind of why I'm like, can we all just kind of say that they're pretty much equal and that kind of thing?
Isn't that kind of what Layla was just doing?
No, Layla was trying to get Quinn to admit that they are the same level of threat, not that Team Storm is worse.
Oh, okay.
What's hurting Layla is that Quinn is consistently saying that the Ascendants are worse than Team Storm, and Layla's like, that's who killed my family and the families of hundreds of others of people over the years.
And enslaved children.
Yeah, and worse. Again, they're Legion.
Yeah.
So yeah, I'm a bit leery of kind of saying that anyone is worse than anyone else.
He's saying in a war situation, the Ascendants, because as far as we know, worst case scenario, the Ascendants already have people inside Team Storm.
Would Spark know anything about that?
They're all about cloak and dagger.
Wait,
That's kind of the shtick.
And like other reasons.
They have spies all over the place. We keep running into them.
Yes, they have spies, yes, but not necessarily always infiltrate the top order. It's always keeping an eye on what's going on. It isn't infiltrate, it is keeping an eye.
That would make Team Storm a near complete mystery to them because the only way to keep an eye on them is to have someone on the island. And the only way to be on the island is if you're either Team Storm or you're one of those slaves.
Well, if you remember what, back when we had tried to convince Joey that Spark was on, had been captured by Team Storm, they were just like, oh yeah, they're a thing. They don't know much about Team Storm other than they're a thing.
Yeah, Spark would know that, like, the Ascendants know about Team Storm's existence, but they're kind of in the same boat as the NUR in that they don't take Team Storm seriously at all. They're just a glorified raider gang as far as the Ascendants are concerned.
Okay.
Anyway, I'm sorry, I've pulled us very far off topic, so I'm very sorry about that. Should we get back to in-character?
Sure. I'll let you guys discuss.
Okay. Where were we?
Look. If there's going to be a war, it doesn't matter who's better than who comes out on top, it doesn't matter. What matters is that it's going to happen. And if you think happens, and there's another freaking great war, it won't matter. What matters is it all needs to be stopped. All of them.
Yeah. Yeah, you're right.
We are capable of that.
We are a group of five. Let's be honest here, misfits who have stopped Team Storm once and caused several inconveniences to Team Ascendants. To the Ascendants. If we really, really are going to do this, we need to do more than just place a bomb on a Tran and send it to the server form.
The difference between us doing that and us stopping that is the one thing we don't have. Information.
Also, we really don't have firepower.
Bigger Tran and send it to the right server room.
Good.
Spark just kind of does Jolene have anything like on her shelves or something that she can like?
Honestly, you're not half wrong. A big enough bomb would go anywhere. Would do fine. The other issue is, as has been pointed out several times, these incidents aren't all bad.
I was asking if Jolene's got any, if Jolene has anything in the house that she can use as kind of like pawns for the map.
Probably something in the knitting basket. There are at least like thread spools.
Yeah.
Spark Gwen has his piece.
Sparkle will just borrow a couple of those. She'll put a couple red ones on top of that battle. She'll put a couple of yellow ones over by where Team Storm is at. She'll put a couple green over where she thinks the kindred is, and then a couple of.
Do we know where the kindred is?
She's guessing. Where from what they were.
You know.
Radio progress.
Okay, we know. Okay.
Do you have the ore map? Still, yes. Or do I need to read it?
I have it somewhere.
They're holed up in what was, pre-war Agate Village.
Okay.
And they very rarely come out. They very rarely make their presence known. They're completely and utterly isolationist.
I see.
What's
Agate
the deal with the kindred again?
Boys, but I don't
Brotherhood.
See. Was Agate Village?
Is it in Agate Forest?
Yeah, Agate Forest.
Okay. So they're actually pretty close to the Ascendants.
Actually, yes.
And they're an X factor, too, because we don't even know if they're going to get in a fight. And if they do, what side they join, if any.
Smart's trying to get to that. She puts a couple on the side from where the direction Quinn said Nerve was coming in. Yes, I'm going to keep calling them Nerve because. And
yeah.
You are.
Yeah, they'll hit Outskirt Stand first. Like, that's what the first town they'll get into.
Okay. Right now we know that Team Storm is moving over here towards the coast. And she just kind of pushes the arms out.
Out of character, do we know if there's anything in the Orre Coliseum?
Isn't the Colosseum still actually used for Colosseum things?
Yes, it's that's
still. Oh, that one.
Okay, so yeah, Quinn is saying that they probably have some kind of staging area somewhere between Gideon Port and the Orre Coliseum.
Probably
in that little inlet right there.
Just a bit further south from Pirate, we don't know. We won't know unless we go and scout the coast.
Well, scouting's a thing we should be pretty good at, right?
Yeah.
Been doing it well so far. I mean, it sounds like what we need to do is gather information. And maybe we need to spread it. Maybe we need to spread it too. I mean, you're right, Quinn. The Ascendants aren't well known to people. Everyone knows that Team Storm exists because they go around raiding towns. But people don't know for sure that the Ascendants do. Maybe we should warn them.
It's a good idea, but there is... I've seen this happen a few times. At least once before, if we start telling people that there's some kind of secret organization with people around that can do things, right, and they believe us, who do they trust? People will start turning on each other.
Out of character, I'm not there, so I'm...
Shelly pops in.
Anyway,
basically, I'm imagining like the synth situation, right? If the enemy is among you, who do you trust?
But what I was going to say is Spark would know this. Spark would, have a suspicion that this would be the case. You have reason to be concerned that if, the spies checking in on the population of New Orre gave their superiors reason to believe that people are starting to suspect their presence and become ever more aware of it, they might straight up attack and just stop surveying. They might straight up attack.
Right.
And I don't think there's anyone on this map that, that's aside from these groups that we're talking about that could withstand that kind of thing.
So, I guess, is Spark going to bring that up?
Yeah, Spark's going to bring that up. It's like, telling people is not necessarily best. What probably should happen is we keep as much of it to ourselves.
Okay, so...
We tell the people we need to, but... Any stir in the general public could lead to chaos.
Yeah, and that's just going to make Team Storm, everything for Team Storm, easier pickings.
Yeah, that's true.
Alola turned out to be real,
Team Storm,
right?
Zero makes everything.
Hmm?
Kindred, it makes everything, everyone easier. They can get what they want out of people if they need it. It's one less thing that they have to worry about.
Okay, so we don't start mass panic then. I mean, no, yeah, of course we don't. Leilani, what were you saying about Alola?
It turned out to be real, right?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So maybe other legends are real, and they might be powerful enough to help us.
Like what?
I don't know. But
well, Shelly did say that we had them. Like, they exist.
Legendary Pokemon?
Friendly. Yeah, they're not too friendly to our kind.
Oh.
Well, they'd be in trouble too if everything exploded.
Legendary
they
creatures.
Would be, but we'd have to convince them of that.
Convincing.
And
that sounds easier
you
than
know what?
Fighting them.
Convincing
yeah,
legendary creatures? What about the Vions?
Vions, we can grab. Apparently not.
Wait, out of character. Bucky, would it be fair to assume that Quinn knows that there's a broodmother, considering he's like done like training and stuff with Cypress?
There is not a single broodmother.
Oh, like, no, of course not. But like a broodmother is a thing, right? She's like the hierarchy of groups.
Yeah, like brood, you know, Vion packs typically have a broodmother who know, leads them and breeds with all the males and whatnot. So yeah, Quinn would know that.
We could get firepower from the Realgum Tower.
I mean,
well, yeah, but my point is, there's a lot of powerful things out here who have a vested interest in not being dead. Let's just talk to them.
But Realgum Tower might be a good place to start. Leilani, you're right, there are legendary things out there, and one of the biggest mysteries in this area is Realgum Tower. There's always been talk that there's some kind of big power there, but no one can go in because of the Vions, but if we talked to the Vions, if we brought Moors and Cypress...
It's gonna be tough. I mean, look, I'm good at what I do, and y'all are good at just convincing them to be friends in general, but that's gonna be tough.
Well, everything is going to be tough. Even running is going to be tough.
We don't have much of a choice.
We're not running.
I know. I know that. I'm not going anywhere.
Okay.
Kind of literally, actually.
What?
I know this is a bad time.
I'm looking at her feet now.
Sorry?
Spark is just looking down at her feet.
I know this is a bad time, but... With all this stuff that's going on, and the trouble I've got into before, I mean, I know all of us did, but I'm the youngest, and my mom's worry. I had a long talk with them, and I promised them that I'd stay home for a while. Just until I can train a bit, to get stronger, so that I'm not gonna freeze up again when it matters. But with all this stuff that's going on... Sorry, go ahead.
Yeah, no, Quinn's like, how far are you allowed to leave?
Well, we kind of talked about it, and we said that after I'd done some training at home and stayed within the confines of the city, that I could maybe start going outside the city limits, as long as maybe Gwen or Ariel came with me.
Okay, so no Oasis.
Well, that's kind of what I was thinking, actually. Maybe they would let me go to Oasis. If I had people go with me, like Gwen and Ariel, I have to talk to them about this, but if I'm going to be staying here and working on getting stronger, I should be doing other useful stuff too, to prepare for what's going to happen. So I can start talking to Lisa.
Well, Oasis is already on our side, aren't they?
They are.
Know.
They are, yeah. What I'm saying is, I can talk to Lisa and maybe say if maybe... Maybe see if any of the guards could help us. I think she should know about the situation, and she can decide who she needs to tell in the city. And then if either I or you guys or someone can go to Oasis and start coordinating with them. And remember, the Costa family are going to be stopping at Oasis in like a couple days to pick up supplies. I think
Out of character, have we seen them yet?
No.
But
we know they're going to be at Oasis. If you remember, we were going to go back to Oasis and recruit them to help free people from the Under.
That's a good thing she can do, because I think...
So,
yeah, that's a good thing she can end up doing.
Bucky, can you remind me how far Oasis is from Phenac?
Sorry, I dropped my phone.
right, that's what that was.
What was I saying? Oh, yes.
Oasis and Phenac.
Yeah, I'm thinking. If you have a ride Pokemon, which I'm sure someone in town would be willing to loan you, since mm-hmm. you're just one person, three if you count Gwen and Ariel.
Oh, got a bit of someone's rustling or clattering. Okay, sorry, it stopped. Yeah.
Never mind.
But yeah, with a few ride Pokemon that someone just loaned you for a few hours, yeah, it'd just take about 3 hours to get there, I'd say.
Okay. In which case she says, I'll talk to Mum and Mama about it. Once they realize, just... Once I explain to them what you said, Quinn, about how this is going to get really bad, I think they'd be okay with it. Especially if, well, if Gwen and Ariel and I can train a bit for the next few days, then we can set out to Oasis, make the trip there, in time to rendezvous with the Costa family, and let them know what's going on. I know they're just three people, but they're a force to be reckoned with. They took on a gang of slavers all by themselves. So I think we should have them on side. And Oasis mm-hmm. as well, of course. And sorry, go ahead.
No, I was going to ask out of character. Do we know when they, like, the force is getting here? Or did the radio just say, we'll be coming?
I think they just said, we will be coming. We don't know what the time is.
Yeah, it just said, you know, basically, all these other factions are mobilizing, but fear not, because we will protect you, is basically what it said.
Okay, that actually could be bad for us, because if... Because this was, like, this wasn't just, like, an isolated thing. This was a radio broadcast, like, sent out over all of New Orleans.
Mm-hmm.
If,
so the Ascendants and Team Storm know.
Yeah, so they might, like, Ascendants... Like, Ascendants are already, like, gaining advanced technology. Like, they're putting types to items. Team Storm might realize, you know, oh, they're coming to stop us. We need to move up our timescale. Quinn's going to say that, you know, at best, we have a couple of days, like 3 or 4 days before things really start getting, things really start cracking down.
We do our best to gather as much information we can in that time.
That being said, it might be best that we split up.
Jake.
And cover more ground.
Don't split the party.
I know, but yeah.
Wait. Jake. I mean, I don't... We'd have to check with him if it was okay, because, you know, we don't want to put him in too much danger, but Spark, you said Jake...
The door opens and Jake peeks inside. Yes?
Jake, were you eavesdropping?
Little bit.
Well, okay. Jake, how much of your psychic powers can you control?
I've been getting pretty good at it. I can read minds now, I can communicate through telepathy, and I can pick stuff up without touching it. And then Eggsy starts to float off the ground.
Whoa.
It's happening again!
Jake, I think you might be a legendary Pokemon.
I don't know about that.
But... Well, I guess, point one, do you think you'd be able to help us? And point two, would you have to ask your dad's permission?
He actually laughs, like that was in character.
Yes.
And he goes, I should, but I'm almost an adult now, so there's not much he can do about it.
I guess.
I mean, yeah, of course I'll help. New Orre is my home.
She grins. You're a good person.
I try.
So, as long as, like, you were with the group, and, like,
Spark was keeping, I mean, everyone was keeping you safe, then maybe you could read some minds of if we could get you close to Ascendance, or
Wait.
Darlene quietly begins putting barf bags in her knitting basket.
Can he Can he just straight read people's minds? Mm-hmm. Oh my god, he could be a Ascendance detector.
So
like that way we can like when we find allies, he can read their mind and determine whether or not they're working for Ascendance or they're for real.
Hey everyone. I guess does this change our plan about freeing the people who were trapped in the under?
Fuck no.
Okay, good. See, I was worried because with all this stuff happening, I thought maybe it wouldn't be important anymore, but I think it is still important because if they're still stuck in there in those cages when all this goes down, then they're going to get killed, and they should be allowed to run, so if we get them out, then
It'll take a bit more time to actually get them out, but we will get them out.
Okay, good.
Honey, I wrote the gentleman down there an IOU, and I keep my promises.
Layla smiles.
Sarah is inexplicably standing next to Jolene.
Layla just smiles and says, "You're a good influence."
That's a sweet thought.
Okay. I'm not sure who she was talking to in that.
She was talking to Jolene. She was like looking at Jolene.
Yeah, Sarah just says, "I hate cages."
Yeah. Yeah, cages are the worst. I mean, not the worst. There are other... Cages are the worst for me. Okay, so... I know what I'm doing. I'm gonna stay here and... go to Oasis and talk to the Costas and Garfield and everyone. And Lisa. I can talk to Lisa. What are you guys gonna do? Where are you gonna go?
I think we need to split the party.
We need
eyes on the possible location of Team Storm, and we also need whatever. Hell, even just the information on what's in Realgum Tower would benefit us greatly.
Here is what I'm going to suggest. Just kind of grabs like a marker or something, and just kind of draws like a dotted line going pretty much south of Phenac, underneath Pirate Town, over past by the kind of where that little bay is on the map above Orre Coliseum, a straight line to Agate Forest, and then a line to Realgum Tower.
So we just make a giant circle? I remind you that we have a giant moving metal tower in our group and isn't the best at stealth. Is she snoring right now?
If you're talking about Aaron, you know there are Pokeballs, right?
Yes, and her owner is not quite that different. Jolene is an amazing ally, and yes, can hold her own in a fight, but stealth is not her forte.
Not everyone has to go in the base. And we may not necessarily need to go in the base.
If we are doing the giant circle and on the lookout for any possibility of Team Storm activity, if they see us, blown.
Not necessarily. They might think we're just a group of wanderers.
Real quick, could you tell me again what the locations were that you're going to?
Okay, we're proposing. Go south around Pyrite, kind of cut, and then follow the coast up into about north of Coliseum, to where that kind of like the middle of that bay is, and then a straight line for
the agate forest, and then a straight line to Rialba.
Okay. What is Gaty on anywhere now? Anywhere near that route? Out of interest.
Not really. I mean, we could make a detour to get there, but it would take us out of the way.
Yeah. Layla is
closest
going
to Agate.
Layla, Agate. Yeah, Agate Forest, and then Gaty on you. Layla crouches down. Wait, do we have an actual map that we're looking at?
Quinn has drawn one. Yes.
Okay, so we have that map as well. Okay.
Yeah.
She taps on Gaetion Port. I don't know if it's a good idea or not, but if you went to Gaetion, then you could rendezvous with Moors, who might be willing to help. At least possibly talk your way into Rialgam Tower. And, well, them being on the seafront and all that, plus they've got those Gyarados that you asked to help them, Quinn.
Yep, Gary. I remember Gary.
Yeah, maybe Gary and his friends have been looking out for Team Storm activity, so maybe they're in a good location to kind of see if there's any activity coming from Cynodark Island.
Hell, if nothing else, the telling the town that things are going down might be good, and they might owe us a favor, all things considered.
I don't know if
Mars is always fucking ready to help!
Since Gaetion Port is still rebuilding, I'm not 100% sure how able they'd be to help us, but at the very least we can warn them and they can fortify in case of another... When another attack happens.
Yeah, Gaetion Port is weak at the moment. They have good resources and staging ground, so yeah, it's a matter of time.
We can make a quick stop then and take a bit of a detour.
Same with the Colosseum.
There's nothing at the Colosseum.
Yeah, that it's the Colosseum itself. It's a good large structure that can easily be fortified.
It's in use, Hunter.
Yeah, no, that's what I'm saying, is if they could attack the Orre Colosseum. And if no one's there, then they easily take it. If it is in use, then there's going to be a fight.
Is it worth...
This is a lot of out-of-character speculation, which, you know, there's logic behind it, definitely. But is it worth maybe making a roll to kind of see if that's... Because I'm kind of aware that, you know, there's how Hatter would see things playing out and how Bucky would see things playing out and how it might be helpful for Quinn to roll to kind of see what might happen strategically, and then Bucky can give a better idea. Does that make sense?
Okay. Is that okay with you, Bucky?
Sure.
Buck. Oh, there you are.
What would you have me roll? Intuition?
That's what I'm thinking, but let me check just to make sure. Intuition.
Yeah, because, like, I think we've had this conversation before about guile's not how clever you are.
No. Guile is fooling people. And charming.
That's cool, the only 1 point difference. 23. That's pretty average.
Yeah, it's pretty average. It's a little bit up in the air.
I was going to say, what the hell did you guys put all your skill points into? But then I remembered stealth.
Well, I actually have a lot of skill points because of one of my classes. I actually have a thing, like, if it's not going to give me, like, it's pretty average. I almost kind of want to re-roll it with my, thing.
If you want.
I'm trying to find it. Sorry, it's just been so long.
Yeah, that's fair.
Ah, okay. Sorry, 31.
Okay. Alright, so just to double check and make sure, like, what are you asking specifically?
Like, strategically for Team Storm, what would make the most sense of what they're going to do?
They are hyper-aggressive, so It makes sense that once they reach land, they would immediately try to find a good staging ground, a good base of operations on the mainland instead of just their island.
Mm-hmm.
So, and like you said, the Orre Coliseum is a pretty good landmark. It's pretty fortifiable, relatively speaking. It's it doesn't have as many people that they'd have to take out as, say, Pyrite Town or Gadeon Port. So they could basically just steamroll any, you know, anyone hanging around there and just take it with relative ease. So yes, Orre Coliseum, there is probably going to be a target very soon if it hasn't already been taken.
Yeah, and that actually puts them like scarily...
You know, like, it's sad.
What was that?
It's like an emotional blow. Like it's a well-known, cherished landmark of the area.
True. Yeah, it's it's like the aliens blowing up the White House.
Yeah.
Okay, so yeah, also, good call. Aliens good always call,
blow up, you know, the White House, the Eiffel Tower. It's the same shit.
Yeah. Though Team Storm itself, I don't think would think of that about that, but the leader might.
I mean, from obviously he's Bucky's character, and we've only seen him once, but it strikes me that that demoralizing the enemy would very much be up the street.
He does strike me as intelligent.
He is definitely.
Yes.
Sorry.
No, it's fine.
I have feelings about this character that I need to keep under my hat. For reasons.
Yeah. Reasons. But so he will probably be like, attack or Coliseum, because it's so, you know, it's such a great thing to attack, and he knows it's gonna be a blow to everybody. And it also puts them scarily close to Pyrite Town.
Yes, it does.
And thus Phenac City.
Pyrite Town also potentially allows them to gather allies.
And then there's the Under.
Then there's the Under.
Oh.
Yeah. So that's the kind of thing that we need to check on, like, immediately.
Yeah, you're right.
Definitely. Like I said, we don't have much time. I hate saying it, but I feel like splitting the party might be the best option. I
really don't think it is!
Splitting the party is a fucking terrible idea every single time.
It's always gone badly.
Actually, oh god, no, in this game,
splitting the party.
Yeah, but Layla's not going off and doing anything dangerous by herself. She's sticking to Phenac and Oasis. She's not gonna do anything dangerous. If y'all split the party, it's gonna be two people per incredibly dangerous activity.
Oh no.
What?
This isn't Avatar where we're getting, like, about this size party going to each thing.
Yeah, no, okay, so, like, Quinn's gonna look down at the thing and, like, look at Orre Coliseum and just draw a line from that to Oasis.
What?
Oh no.
There is nothing between these two locations.
Oh no.
Nothing but empty desert.
And a very angry old woman with a shotgun.
Yes, a very old lady with a shotgun.
Layla stands
Coliseum,
up.
Oasis could be next.
Layla stands up. So I'm thinking maybe I should push up the time scale, ask Mom and Mama if maybe we could just leave a little bit sooner to go to Oasis.
Yeah, Oasis.
The remark about the angry old woman with a shotgun was in character.
Yeah, no, and Quinn reached
back on.
With an old lady and a shotgun, yes. Wait a minute, question. Do we know where the SS Libra's wreck is?
Yeah, actually, it's kind of a landmark. It's typically, you know, just a place where people hole up when they need a place to hole up. But lately, it has been growing into a little settlement of its own.
Kind of like a small, what's the name of it from Fallout 3?
I know what you're talking about.
The Rivet City.
Oh, Rivet City.
Yeah, Rivet City.
Yeah, it's a miniature Rivet City.
Yeah, it's turning into a small town version of Rivet City. Yes.
Rivet Village.
Rivet Village,
yes.
Yeah, I like that. Rivet Town.
Rivet Town.
Rivet
Town. Good.
I like it.
Yeah. So that's, right?
Libra Borough.
Oh. Yes.
I like that, yeah. I like that. Yeah, so, like, we need to check the Coliseum. We need to check on Oasis. We need to, like, scan that coast. And we need to hit Rialgum Tower.
Oh, we got our work cut out for us.
Yeah, that's why.
We could get people to do other things for us.
That's true.
How much we can
Well, true,
we have
yeah.
connections.
But Quinn's not going to be like, I'm going to send these guys to Realgum Tower. No. He's not
like, going to do that. I think we should be the ones to go to Realgum.
Yeah. But other people can do the other things.
Okay. Wait a minute.
Maybe we can use Jake and Kane to our advantage and Issa.
Yes.
Well,
wait.
Jake,
Jake,
Kane, and Issa are, yeah.
So, you know, he's like, all of this isn't character. He, like, points to... Sorry, out of character. I totally forgot Eli's character's name. It's been
Leilani.
So long.
Leilani.
He points to Leilani. You still have the flying one, right? Oh, the Ascendant's
Kali?
Pokemon. Kali, yes. You still have her, right?
That, yes. I mean, I don't have her, but if she would be willing to help, I could ask her.
She is still sitting malevolently on the roof, if that's what you're asking.
Yeah, no. You could, like, out of character, even though Eli doesn't have, like, the flyer or whatever, the rider class, can he still ride?
I'm gonna say so.
Okay. I maybe not well or do anything fancy, just ride.
Yeah, like, no fancy abilities or anything, but, yeah. Like, he can totally ride Pokemon.
Take that.
Like, anyone can ride Pokemon.
Fly over Orre Coliseum, see how it's doing, and if there's something like, you know, something's going on, fly back and tell us. If not, you know, land and tell them, you know, something might happen and to be prepared. And if nothing's happening, you know, just skirt the coast and then fly back.
I think I could do that. I can actually do that right now.
Yeah. While that's happening, Layla can be going to Oasis, checking that out. I think we need to talk with Lisa. Is Lisa the name of the out of character?
She's
Lisa's
mayor,
the name.
Yes. Yes.
Is the mayor?
Yes.
Oh. Yeah. We talked to Lisa. She's at least on our side, right?
Yes.
Yeah, that was actually in character. She's on our side, right?
Oh God.
By the way, who has to bird a bird? Who did we give that to? Gideon Port?
Lisa.
Isn't it?
No.
No. Yeah. No. Andrew wait.
No, it's at the farm, isn't it?
No, it's not at the. We definitely sold it to someone.
I believe we either gave it to Dust. We gave it to Dust or Lisa. Sorry. Yeah, Bucky.
I'm pretty sure you sold it to Gideon Port in exchange for a house.
That's yeah, and
right.
then we
okay, so
and we sold the fuel to Phenac City.
That's right.
In like you know every week or every month or so, some money will be given to the family to
the Hardigan Lamonts.
Yeah, the Hardigan Lamont family to you know help them off
to do certain things.
Yeah, you know, small little thing to
certain
you know
things.
Say thanks. Some things.
Fucking
but
what?
Yeah, if we tell her everything that's going on. We can do a thorough investigation of all the guardsmen, right?
Oh, in case any of them are ascendants.
Just in case, right?
Or Storm.
Or Storm, yeah. Either one, because they both have identifying marks, don't they?
Ooh.
Do
Storm have identifying fatal. Marks?
Soldiers taken as slave children do.
Yeah, like Layla, like Layla and her sisters.
Jolene is not comfortable with a strip search witch hunt.
Yeah.
Okay.
That's fair.
Yeah, I don't think we don't need to do a strip search. We can, I mean, if we do this, we could ask Jake to read their minds.
Yes.
Maybe.
Right.
Yes,
yeah.
Because that's less invasive.
Okay.
I was gonna suggest sending possibly Jake and Kane and maybe Issa to Gideon, and have them check in for us.
Yeah? Do you think they could handle that? Jake, do you think you could handle that?
I mean, maybe.
How are you doing, by the way? If you... Wait. Did Jake get shot? No.
Jake didn't get shot.
No.
Jake's dad got shot. Kane got beat That's up. It. Jake didn't get hurt.
Yeah, well, okay. Jake also was beat up when you first... found when he first arrived in Phenac, but he recovered relatively quickly.
Okay, so he's okay.
Yeah.
He's not dead.
He's not dead.
Yeah.
He's dead.
Not quite dead.
feels happy.
Shut up, you. You're fooling nobody.
And hold on a sec. I'm not sure if I started that yet. Shit, I'm not sure.
I'm not saying Kaimana goes with, but Kaimana goes with. Actually, that might be... Kaimana? Sending Kaimana with Issa might be a bad idea, actually.
Which Kaimana, she's Leilani's sister.
She has has the tact of a spoon.
Yeah. Do not send Kaimana with Issa.
Yeah. We might as well
just detonate the nukes ourselves.
I thought better of it as soon as it was out of my mouth.
Yeah.
Ariel, on the other hand.
We could send her somewhere. She's basically a solid brick of muscle.
We're picking up all our lovely Kaimana NPCs and going, right, let's send you guys into mortal peril. Sorry, yes, Hannah?
And everyone fires over the top of them until all the Ascendants are dead.
Bullets bounce off of them and back into the Ascendants.
Good.
Anyways. Jake looks uncertain and he goes, I mean, I could, I guess. Maybe.
Well, we'd have to talk to the others about it anyway.
Yeah.
Listen, we've got these. She taps her earpiece. To keep in touch, and Sprig's gonna stay with you guys while I'm gone. Sprig, you stay with Spark, okay? Sprig nods and sits on Spark's head. If that's everything for now, I'm gonna go talk to Mom and Mama and Gwen and Ariel and stuff.
Well, so the main plan is, right, just to clear all of it out. There's the character. Clear it all, make it all clear. Any gripes, tell me. We get Leilani to fly over Old Coliseum, see how that's doing. If nothing's wrong, fly the coast and report back. We send Jake and who else?
Kane and maybe Issa.
And maybe Issa to Gideonport. And then the rest of us hit Real. Oh, and Layla goes to Oasis.
We go first to Agate Forest, and then on the way back, we head out the Algo.
Why are we going to Agate Forest?
Investigate the Kindred.
Yeah. Because we have nothing on them. We need to get information on them.
Yeah, but I'd rather hit Rialgum Tower while we're full and healthy. And actually, having some muscle behind us might help us with the Kindred.
I'm more worried about the Kindred having just nothing on them.
I'm not saying not go to the Kindred. I'm just saying go to Rialgum first.
Well, I would like, again, also, maybe wait until, if we can time this right, maybe link up with Jake, Kane, and Lisa coming back with Maz, and then go Rialgum Tower. Just having that one extra Vion with us going in.
I don't know. I know how comfortable I am putting Jake and Issa and going into Rialgum.
Jake goes, you guys want some pancakes?
That would be nice.
Okay. War strategy with pancakes. Let's go.
He goes, it just sounds like you guys could use a break is all.
Actually, yeah, that sounds good, Jake. Why don't we all head back to our place and get something to eat, and maybe that'll help us think a bit more clearly.
Jake brightens a bit, nods, and starts heading back. And I'm guessing you guys,
we follow, I think.
Yeah.
I think so. That's what it sounds like.
Quinn hangs back for a little while, and then follows.
And with that, since I kind of want to wrap up early because, we're starting again and, getting
back into the swing of things, and we started late, so we're a bit tired. And also, this way, you realize that we can call next week's session Pancake Planning Party.
Oh my god, yeah.
Oh my god.
Damn it.
Okay, I'm down with that. And not just that, but, like, you've given Bucky a lot to think about and a lot to plan for, so...
Yeah, dude, I've been thinking about this for a while.
Silly me going, Hatter, maybe you should check with Bucky and see if that's the kind of thing that they'd actually do. No, it is. And if it wasn't before, it is now. Okay.
Honestly!
I've been sitting here looking at this map for, like, days, being like...
So what we learn here is Quinn's gain is also Bucky's gain.
Sorry. No, I was sitting here looking at this map, and Quinn was probably the same, thinking, if I was this evil organization, what would I do?
If I was this evil DM, what would I do?
Yeah, if I was this guy, what would I do?
Dear. All right, so I think, yeah, we should
all right. Hold the session. With that, thank you all for playing with me. Thank you, Bucky, for DMing, and thank you, Dally, for streaming.
And thank you all for bearing with us during our hiatus and for joining us again whenever you're listening to this. Thank you all, and take care, and good night.